Listen, with Borderlands the pre-sequel about a week away, it's time to start preparing yourself. No, I'm not talking about starting a new Borderlands 2 character or downloading all that Headhunter DLC. No, honestly, that wouldn't be a bad start. I'm talking about your mental game. You don't just want to be good at the game when it comes out. You don't want to be merely great at shooting things on a weird-ass moon. You want to be
legendary.
And since the only way to accomplish anything in life anymore is to follow a list on the internet, we've assembled this quick and easy guide to becoming
legendary
in Borderlands, the pre-sequel, for you and your fellow Vault Hunter friends to enjoy and cherish. Step 1. Get boozed up. Look, I'm not saying you need to drink to be cool, just that you'd be a lot cooler if you drank. But you don't have to take my peer pressure for it. Head on over to Moxie's Up Over Bar and peruse the merchandise yourself. If Elpis had a health code, it'd probably be a serious violation for Moxie to just leave the drinks out on the bar for you to purchase, but just look at the stat boost these suckers will give you. Plus 30% melee damage for downing Brick's fist. That'll make even Claptrap's pathetic poke attack pack a punch. Slurp down a Phenalian toddy and get a 20% increase to damage resistance. Let's see those Kragans barf lava on you now. Haha, space skags, I find this refreshing and not at all uncomfortable. There are 8 of these Moxtails on display and no bouncer in sight, so throw down some Moonstone, throw back a drink, and enjoy 30 minutes of a temporarily juiced up you. Only one can be active at a time, so choose wisely, and yes, I said Moonstone, so spend wisely. On with the list! Step 2, in Borderlands the pre-sequel, equip
legendary
weapons. I mean, yeah, it's a bit of a no-brainer, but what'd you expect? So check out these two
legendary
beauties we got to test drive. The Cutting Edge Fatale. Name seems a tad redundant, but when you consider that this SMG is basically built to quickly freeze enemies so you can dice them up with those two pokey bits, it certainly seems to fit. Smashing frozen enemies is one of the great new pleasures in the pre-sequel, and doing so with a gun named after the 1992 drama romance sport classic The Cutting Edge?
Legendary.
The ZX-1 is the other weapon we got to fool around with, and let me tell ya, this is one hot little number. Yes, that's an elemental damage pun, and no, I feel no shame. A 100% accurate fiery laser beam that penetrates enemies and becomes burst fire when zoomed? I mean, I'm not totally sold on that last stat, but what the hell? Sign me up! Just gotta make sure you find yourself some atmosphere with this one, because you know what they say. In atmosphere, fire burns dear. In void of space, you can't melt face. Atrocious. Our last tip for becoming
legendary
is step 3. Butt stomp everything everywhere all the time forever. Okay, look, I know what you're thinking. But if I'm butt stomping all the time, how will I use my
legendary
weapon? Well, for one, you probably won't pick up a weapon right off the bat, so you need something to kill the time. And for two, shut up and start butt stomping. Butt stomp people. Butt stomp Kragans. Butt stomp giant floating mutated squid horror. Okay, no, that's gross. Just stay in your moon buggy. Butt stomp dudes outside. Butt stomp dudes inside. Butt stomp even if you're a tweaky little robot with no actual butt. Butt stomp near. Butt stomp far. Butt stomp in your hover car. Butt stomp here. Butt stomp there. Butt stomp freaking everywhere. So there you have it. The top 3 ways to become a
legendary
moon badass in Borderlands the pre-sequel, courtesy of GameSpot.com for you, our beloved viewer. Study this video extensively, and you too will be ready to live the legendary life when your bizarro moon adventures begin. Yeah, I know I didn't use the voice. No, I was tired of it. I can't say legendary that way one more time. No, I won't do it.
Legendary.
God damn it.